Other news, the Philippine Navy deploys two new fast attack ships following commissioning rites in Manila. Our correspondent Bianca Davao joins us on the line with the details. Bianca?
Hi, Ron. The Philippine Navy formally commissioned on Monday its two recently acquired fast attack interdiction craft missiles named after two Medal of Valor awardees. The BRP Nestor Acero and the BRP Lolinato Toong were sent off and deployed to their place of assignment. Philippine Navy Flag Officer in Command Rear Admiral Toribio Agassi Jr. said they will be prioritizing areas in the West Philippine Sea and Southern Philippines. The two vessels were delivered by the Israel Shipyards Limited last September. The ships are the first two of nine acquired by the Department of National Defense with a budget of 10 billion pesos, inclusive of missile and weapon systems. Four more units are slated to be delivered beginning next year, while the remaining three will be constructed at the Philippine Navy Shipyard in Naval Station Pascua-Ledesma in Cavite City. Adasi added, the Navy is also planning to acquire 15 more of these Acero-class patrol gunboats. These vessels have a displacement of about 95 tons, a maximum speed of above 40 knots, and a range of 1,000 nautical miles. They also have an endurance of 6 days. The Navy chief said additional vessels will help the Navy meet the requirements in patrolling the seas of the country. Ron?
Bianca Davao with that story. Thanks, Bianca. The Philippines' Environment Secretary urges the private sector to help address the impacts of climate change at a sustainability forum. For more on this, we have on the line Willard Cheng. Willard?
Hi, Ron. ENR Secretary Maria Antonio Yulo Gonzaga called for private sector support to address the impact of climate change, even as the world is likely to miss its target to keep warming of temperature to 1.5 degrees. Speaking at the Sustainability Forum PH 2022, organized by the SM Group in partnership with WWF Philippines, Yulo Gonzaga urged stakeholders not to give up on the target, even as the adaptation and emission gap reports of the UN Environment Program, or UNEP, said that the world is on the way to at least 2.8 degrees of warming based on current nationally determined contribution, or NDC, policies and performance globally, and that the world is now at 1.1 degrees above pre-industrial temperatures and could possibly breach 1.5 degrees by mid-2030s. The reports, she said, stressed the need to combine adaptation and mitigation, emphasize prevention, and the need for adaptation financing to avoid the harmful effects and risks from climate change. She said private sector has emerged as a critical factor in bridging the cost of financing climate action with energy transition and just transition of labor towards net zero carbon emission. Secretary Gonzaga also urged private sector to work with the DNR and help establish a national risk register that will serve as basis to determine gaps, needs, and priorities of development plans, build a national natural resource geospatial database that will provide the baseline inventories, provide expert insights as environmental laws are being reviewed, and continue to mainstream climate and disaster resilience into their core business cycles. Meantime, SM Investments Corporation President and CEO Frederick Dibuncio stressed SM's commitment to advance the country's climate agenda, support the country's commitment to reduce greenhouse gas emissions by 70%, and work with stakeholders in working on climate change adaptation and disaster resilience. He said SM has allotted 10% of its capital expenditure to incorporate disaster resiliency and sustainability in infrastructure designs, equip people and communities in disaster preparedness, and advocate for disaster resiliency among local governments and international communities. Hansi Jr., President of SM Engineering Design and Development Corporation, recommitted SM to climate action and called for an accelerated effort to support the Philippine climate agenda. He cited SM's construction of LEED-certified buildings, its shift to renewable energy sources, and tree and mangrove planting, among others. Worldwide Fund Philippines Chairperson Maria Isabel Garcia pointed out the twin challenges facing the world: climate crisis and biodiversity crash, saying the world's old ways failed, and urged aligned measures to address the challenges. Today's forum also featured a panel discussion with industry leaders on what their respective companies have done and plan to do to support climate change adaptation and mitigation efforts. Ron?
Thanks for that, Willard Cheng.